if you're not choosing the fear of the Lord, you're not choosing wisdom. All
right, that's right.
That was it today.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever. Psalms 112. Praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that fears the Lord, that delights it greatly in his commandments.
Said, blessed is the man that fears the Lord, man. So, you know, by us fearing him and loving him, you know, we gonna be blessed, man. Within his truth, man. And not, you know, and not going off and not obeying by the commandments, man.
It tell you in the scriptures, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
That's right. That's right.
All
right.
So if you want to get wisdom, you have to have the fear of the Lord on you, man. You know, because for you to come out here to even teach this true hell, you gotta have the fear of the Lord on you, man. You afraid you know what the Lord do to you, man. You know, if you don't obey, you know what I'm saying? Perfect example is Jonah, man.
Yeah.
Somebody get that when the whale swallowed Jonah.
Got it.
You know? Jonah, he didn't obey the Lord. The Lord told him to go prophesy against Nineveh.
Yeah.
And he didn't, man.
I got it. All
right. Only people we really should be fearing is Yahweh Bashiach, man.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. All right. You should have a certain fear of your masters. All right. The man that rule over you, man. All right. Because it says, servants obey your masters with all fear and trembling.
Yep.
You know.
You want that now?
Yeah. All
right. This is Jonah. One, and I'm gonna start it. I'm gonna start at 5.
Hey, somebody get that in Acts. I think it's 6 and 2. You have to obey God rather than man.
Rather than man, yeah.
Come on. You know?
He said, he says, Jonah, he said, then the mariners, which is the mariners on the boat, the mariners were afraid and cried every man unto his God. Man,
right.
That's beautiful, man, because it shows that our power is different from these heathen nations, man. Let me read that again. It says, then the mariners were afraid and cried every man unto his God.
Uh-huh.
And cast forth the wares that were in the ships unto the sea to lighten it of them. But Jonah was gone down into the side of the ship, and he lay and was fast asleep. So the shipmaster came unto him and said unto him, what meanest thou, O sleeper? Arise, call upon thy God, if so be that the power will think upon us that we perish not.
Yeah, because the Lord brought that storm just because his ass was
disobedient. That's right.
He was disobedient, man.
That's right.
You know?
All right.
Go ahead.
He said, that we perish not. Verse 7. And they said, every one to his fellow,
uh-huh,
come and let us cast lots, uh-huh, that we may know for whose cause this evil is upon us.
Right. So they knew some kind of evil was coming upon them.
Yep.
Because, you know, because that storm was, hey, this man's about to take that boat under, man.
Just hold that.
You know?
Yeah.
broke out here with me.
All right. Uh-huh. And they said, so yeah, and they said, everyone, fellow, come and let us cast lots that we may know for who caused this evil is upon us. So that the lots, so cast the lots. And the lot fell upon Jonah. Then said they unto him, tell us, we pray thee, for. He said, tell us, we pray thee. He said, yeah, tell us then, we pray thee, for whose cause this evil is upon us. What is thine occupation? And whence comest thou? What is thy country? And who, and of what people art thou?
Right, hey, he probably was, they probably was having a nice boat ride. To everything was going on, moving to Jonah got on the damn boat, man.
Right.
Three.
All right. And he said unto them, I am a Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, the power of heaven.
I fear the Lord.
Yeah.
But he didn't obey the Lord.
That's right.
You know?
These niggas now. All right. The power of heaven, which hath made the sea and the dry land, and were the men exceedingly afraid, and said unto him, why hast thou done this? For the men knew that that he fled from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them.
Right. So he was free. See, that's the thing. Get that in I think it's one in Acts and it's one in Hebrews. Why do you resist the Holy Ghost, man?
God.
You know? You can't resist the Lord, man. All right. Like you say in Proverbs, man's goings is of the Lord, man.
Right.
You know? And if you try to resist him, hey, he gonna do something to you to make you serve him, man. He can kill your family, you know. He can put you in a bad car crash. Any of those things, man.
Right.
The Lord can do that, man.
All right. Then said they unto him, what shall we do unto thee, that the sea may be calm unto us? For the sea wrought and was temperous. And he said unto them, take me up and cast me forth into the sea. So shall the sea be calm unto you, for I knew that for my sake this great tempest is upon you. Nevertheless, the men rode hard to bring it to land, but they could not.
All right, so if the Lord called, hey, somebody get that in Jeremiah 2, the first chapter. So if the Lord call you to this work, man, you gotta do the work, man.
That's right. Yeah.
You gotta hearken to the Lord and go and do the work, man. All right?
All right, fine.
Hey, you got motherfuckers that's been knowing about this truth for years and won't go out and teach, man. You know? They won't edify the body, man. They rather just be on the sideline, man. Yep. You know, instead of just getting into the work, man.
Yep.
Go ahead.
All right. Nevertheless, the men.
Hey, give me that. Who got that in the other one. Why do you resist the Holy Ghost?
I got it.
Yeah.
This is
stiff-hearted.
This is Acts 7:51.
Uh-huh.
It says, ye stiff-necked.
Right, ye stiff-necked, because they can stiff-neck, man. The majority of our people are stiff-necked, man. Two-thirds of our people, mainly, man. And you even got brothers that say this truth that's stiff-necked, man.
Yeah.
Or people that know about this truth that's stiff-necked, all right? That's taking a long-ass time to serve the Lord that you know what I'm saying, they don't want to obey the Lord, you know? That don't want to do the work of the Lord. And also, we're going to read that. I'm going to expound on the read.
He said, ye stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart.
Yeah.
And is ye do always resist the Holy Ghost.
Yeah, you always resist the Holy Ghost, the spirit of Yahweh Bashiach Messiah. You resist the Holy Ghost. Okay? Perfect example is a lot of these guys, they don't want to come up on the GMS, man. That's part of resisting the Holy Ghost, man.
Right.
Because to have the Holy Ghost is what? It's to have the truth, man. All right? Hey, didn't the Lord say that the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are truth? All right? The spirit and the Holy Ghost is the same thing, man. Okay? Go here, brother.
God, he said, as your fathers did so.
Yeah, as your fathers did so, man. As our forefathers did. And they, you, them same niggas is back, man. You know, when Yahweh Shah came on the scene, man. You know, they ain't come and serve follow Yahweh Shah, man. Matter of fact, they wanted them killed. They wanted them crucified, man.
Right.
Here you go and say the word was made flesh. The walking word actually came down, man. They wouldn't even hearken unto you, man. All right. They had that stiff-hearted resistant spirit, man. Okay?
Do you, that do you spirit.
Go ahead, brother.
I'ma do me, you. Huh. Do you.
It says, as your fathers did so, did you.
Right, did you, man. As your fathers did so, did you. All right? So you got niggas that's coming back in that same light again, man. Doing the same shit over and over and over, man, you know? Being niggas, man. Now when a heart, hey, give me that in Matthew. I've piped into you, and ye have not danced.
Dance, yep.
Give me Ezekiel the second chapter too.
But
before we go too far, still hold that Jeremiah 1:10.
I got it.
Go ahead, Hashem.
He said, so they took up Jonah and cast him forth into the sea.
Go ahead.
And the sea ceased from her raging.
Uh-huh.
Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly and offered a sacrifice unto the Lord.
Yeah, so they even offered a sacrifice unto the Lord, man, when they seen the power, man.
God.
All right, because, hey, like Jonah said, I worship the power of that created the heavens and the earth, man.
Yep.
All right? The waters and he's saying the dry land.
Yeah.
You know? They want to sacrifice it to the Lord because they see the power, man. Which that's what you other nations is going to do anyways eventually, man. You're going to worship the power, man. All right? Either you're going to do it willingly or forcefully.
Will, go ahead. He said, then the Lord expeded the Lord exceedingly and offered up sacrifices to the Lord and made vows.
Uh-huh.
And now the Lord prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah.
Right, and you know what? And the Lord, he's going to get a lot of you motherfuckers that know about this truth and not put no foot towards it, man.
That's right, brother.
Yeah. You know?
Or they
he gonna have a spiritual fish come swallow you up, man.
That's right, brother.
Or like a semi-truck come smack the shit out of you, man. Yeah. Like he did that one nigga, man. You know, that's the semi truck right there, that great fish, man.
Yep.
Except, hey, the Lord's gonna have it. Some people, they just ain't gonna come back from that judgment. He gonna dish out on you.
Yeah. Man.
You know?
Gonna smoke your ass, man.
Go ahead.
He said, now the Lord prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah.
Uh-huh.
And Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and 3 nights.
Yeah, and you know what? The Lord can bring some shit upon you, man. He can bring some type of sickness, disease on you. You know, he can kill your kids.
Yeah.
You know? He can have your fucking car slide into a damn pole, man.
Yeah.
You know? He can have some random nigga just run up on you and beat you the fuck up.
Hey, have you trip and fall up under a bus?
Yeah.
That's why the scriptures say it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power, man.
Right.
All right? That's why, who got that in Acts? Rather obey God. I know I caught a lot of scriptures.
I got that one.
Go ahead.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 5. Verse 26, then went the captain with the officers and brought them without violence, for they feared the people, lest they should have been stoned.
Get right to the point, huh?
Okay, Kai. I'm going to jump down to verse 28. He said, saying, do not we strictly command you that ye should not teach in the name, and behold, ye shall have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine, and instead to bring this man blood upon us. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey the Most High rather than men.
Right, we ought to obey the Most High rather than man, all right? And that's the whole object of our whole entire life, is what? To obey the Most High rather than man. See, like a nigga like Nate, he ain't obeying the Most High. He obeying himself. Really, he's obeying the white man. All right, because he under that 501c3, man. You know, he's pushing the agenda of the so-called white man. All right, which is to teach lies and bullshit, man. All right, which is eventually gonna get his ass killed if his ass don't repent, man, and come back to the true doctrine, man. By teaching his name, man. And that's what when you read into that, read into that chapter, they was getting on them, the apostles, because why? They was teaching a name, you know? Go ahead, brother.
Cut. He said, the power of our fathers raised up Yahweh Shai, whom ye slew and hung on a tree. Him had the power exalted with
his... You can stop right. You made the point.
Cut.
All right, go ahead.
What that Jeremiah
1:5,
1:10?
Hey, man, hey, don't no more readers walk off, man. Shit. Go ahead, man.
Jeremiah 1:10?
No, hold that.
Okay, come.
What you got, brother?
You said you had called for a map the
type. Right, go ahead, get that.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 11.
Do what y'all need, man. Verse, going in and out the scriptures. You can't be walking off and shit. None of you brothers, man.
Verse, book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 17. And saying, we have piped unto you, and ye have not danced.
Right. Which is what we're doing right now, man. What is pipe, man? Playing a song, man. We are piping to you, but ye have not danced, man. Our people are not dancing to this song, man. They being fucking niggas, man. All right, they dancing to the white man's beat though. Every nook and cranny what the white man say do, a nigga gonna dance to it, man. Yes sir, master, I'll pick the cotton. I worship white Jesus. I wants to be in your school.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. That's the spirit of a nigga, man. And them the type of niggas that need to be, which them the type of niggas that the Lord's gonna get rid of. I ain't gonna say need, the Lord is gonna get rid of those niggas, man.
That's right.
You know?
Yep, man. Hey, Steve Harvey is the main one, man. That's the man. He head coon, man. Hey, that's why that nigga ain't can't grow no hair, man.
You don't hear, brother?
And ye have not danced.
Right, ye have not danced, man. The nigga do the Dougie, I'm fresh. Skip to my Lou, whoever the fuck new dance is out, man. Is he gonna dance to this song? No, man. He not, man. He gonna continue. That's why, give me that in Jeremiah. Why do you revolt more and more?
Yeah, you.
Yeah, man. Hey, that's our people, man. And people that's in this truth, too, man. Like the ITR, whatever the fuck they fucking name is, man. Trad and Redad, man. Them niggas, they're not even dancing. I don't know what song them niggas are dancing to, man. But them niggas are coming in the spirit of Cain, man. All right? They some disrespectful, unloyal, all right, two-third-ass niggas, man. Them niggas that's part of that camp is gonna get put to death, man.
That's right.
All right? All you new brothers that's part of that camp, I advise you to get out that shit, all right? Because Nazariah, them niggas, look, how about Shem Yabashah is gonna put them niggas to death, man? Go ahead, read. All right, because this truth is not a game, man. Either you're gonna do the work or you're not. No, really, I ain't gonna say you gotta do the work right, man. Yes, yeah, you can go out there and hold posts, but you gotta do it right, man. The Lord, he set up the man of the Lord, man. He showed us how to do the work right, man.
Yeah.
Do them, man.
Yep.
All right? He set up leaders for the people, man. All right? And you niggas ain't the leaders, all right? Goddamn reprobates.
They trying to sow discord among brethren, man.
Niggas, man.
Hey, that's the thing that's highly despised by Yahweh Shem Yahushua, man.
Man, go ahead. But really, this goes out to, you know, any brother, all brothers that's in this truth, man.
Yeah.
Do the work, man, and do it right. If you've been knowing about this truth, man, you shouldn't be sitting in your damn house eating popcorn. All right? Scratching your damn nuts, man. All right? Ain't putting a foot forward, man.
Yeah.
Then a nigga here still be keeping the Sabbath on Friday. Talking about he know he an Israelite, man.
Yeah, man.
You hey. You goddamn fool. Hey, there's a lot of niggas like that, man.
That's right, man. That's right, brother. But then they want to scoff at the brother, the Simeonite brother. They want to scoff at that brother for making a video, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, at least he trying to do the work, man.
Them goddamn Avengers niggas, when was the last time they feet done touched the concrete? They done been out in the snow. They done been out in the rain.
Mm-hmm.
They haven't, man. All right? The, the hey man, the hey, we're the grunts, man. We're the soldiers of your